Hey guys, so we're back again. We're going to now finally talk about cryptocurrency investing. And Nicole, let me just ask you this. So you obviously have a Robinhood. Do you know what kind of coins are out there? Like, can you name
No
any?
idea. Honestly, the only one I really know of is Bitcoin.
Okay, so Bitcoin is the largest coin, and there's two other coins that we're going to go over, and I'm actually going to click on the top thing. So right now, if you owned all the Bitcoin in the world, it's worth only 56 billion. Wow, that's really depressing.
That's still pretty big.
Yeah, but it used to be much bigger. And what's even more depressing now is Ripple. Have you heard of Ripple? It's the number two coin.
No, I've never heard of that one.
Okay, yeah, so Ripple is the number two coin. I'm gonna kind of go over just the top three, I think is all you really need to know.
What is the difference between Bitcoin, Ripple, and
Ethereum is the third biggest one. Okay. And then let me just go over the market cap so you can see how much bigger of a difference there is. So Bitcoin, I just told you, was worth 56 billion. Ripple is only worth 11 billion. So that's like, what is that? Like 25, it's 20% the value of Bitcoin. And then the next biggest one, Ethereum, is only worth 8 billion. That's it. And the price of Ethereum makes me cry because both of them are very low. Ethereum, you can buy Ethereum right now for $85. At one point, you could have paid $700 for Ethereum. That's pretty depressing. And obviously, did you know Bitcoin's high was 20,000? It hit 20,000 for like one day, and then went crashing down. And now
Why
it's.
does it fluctuate so much?
It's hard to value new things. And so, do you remember when tech companies, the stock market, and like all that stuff? Do you remember the 2000 stock market crash, or no?
2000?
Yeah, like there was a
No.
dot-com boom. Do you know any of that history? Like basically tech stocks, the same thing happened to technology stocks that were related to the internet, including
Is this
Amazon.
2000? Like I was a little kid.
Okay, cool. So I'll educate you. This is something that maybe school should have taught you, but they didn't. So the same thing happened back in 2000, where all these internet companies, went on to the stock market, and they got crazy, crazy valuation because people didn't really know how to value the internet yet. Because even Amazon, it was worth billions of dollars, and people were like, "Oh, like why is Amazon worth $1 billion?" Like it didn't make sense, mailing people books and then like giving your credit card over the internet, right? Like people weren't really doing that back in like 2000, right? But now you go 18 years in the future and everyone's using it and now it has a lot more value. Does that kind of make sense? So it's really hard right now because not a lot of people are using cryptocurrency, and that's one reason it was kind of overvalued. When it had those prices where it was worth 20,000, people were kind of just overvaluing what it was really worth because not that many people use Bitcoin for, transacting or doing exchanges. And then there's a lot of infrastructure that needs to be built. And so I probably am going to make another video that we can talk more about infrastructure. And I guess the way I can try to make it make sense is I'll, because the stock market boom with the internet companies like Amazon, Google, AOL. Do you remember AOL, Nicole, or is that? Okay,
That's cool.
so
That I know.
the way I'll try to explain it to you is also making you look at that because that's another thing too that's really important. If you decide to want to invest, it's really important to understand the history. And it's the same way where like you watch basketball, like you understand basketball way better than like someone who started watching like the Spurs today because you've seen David Robinson, you've seen like all these old school basketball players. So like your knowledge of basketball and if you're like evaluating a team, it's so much better right now because you have like 18 years of watching basketball, right?
Well, over 20.
Yeah, over 20. So and the idea is the same thing with investing. If you take like how you understand sports and like what your knowledge that you've learned over these 20 years, a lot of it is going to be similar to investing. And like how you pick players is the same way how you pick stocks. And like you obviously have to be loyal to one team, but when you're investing in stocks, it's like you're building your own team. So it's like David Robinson is coming and playing. Yeah, you're actually buying your own players and then you hope that your players end up being good, if that makes any
So
sense.
basically like fantasy football.
Yes, fantasy football is more equivalent to stock market investing than, yeah, that's a great way to do it. And you don't do any fantasy sports, correct? right now?
A lot of my friends do.
Okay. So, but like I said, I'll try to like and maybe this will be the easiest way. So, I'll try to make that analogy when I'm explaining things, so that way hopefully it makes a little more sense, but no matter what, the way it's going to make sense is however you started watching basketball and paying attention to basketball. If you do the same thing with investing, whether it's cryptocurrency, real estate, stock market, bonds, whatever you decide, and you might want to focus on all of them, you might want to only focus on one. Over time, it's going to make a lot more sense. There's no way you're going to like understand everything in 1 year or 2 years. It's just the same way of basketball, how it also evolves. Like basketball, the game changes. Investing and like how how money grows, it also changes because everything's always like evolving.
Okay, so how did exactly the Bitcoin come to be,
Okay, so we're
and
gonna make a new
what
video on
exactly
that.
is it?
We'll make a new video on that. So let me go ahead and stop and take a quick break.